बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, आई एम एसन एंड दिस इज़ अ डॉक्यूमेंटेशन वीडियो फॉर द फाइनल प्रोजेक्ट ऑफ द कोर्स CS224 ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग विच इज़ ऑफर्ड इन टर्म स्प्रिंग 2028 हबीब यूनिवर्सिटी। सो द फाइनल प्रोजेक्ट फॉर दिस कोर्स वॉज टू मेक अ गेम विच विल इम्प्लीमेंट ऑल द मेजर पिलर्स ऑफ द ऊब दैट वर टॉट टू अस थ्रू आउट द सेमिस्टर इन ऑर्डर टू अंडरस्टैंड देयर वर्किंग थ्रू एन एक्चुअल एप्लीकेशन सच एज दिस गेम। Topics such as inheritance, polymorphism, data encapsulation were covered through this game using the STL library, which is an open source platform to make 2D games. So for this project, we spent about period of around 2 months. The game design we chose was more or less a replica of Street Fighter, which is an arcade game from the 90s. The reason why we decided to go with this game Street Fighter was solely for the assets, including sounds, images, backgrounds, players, move references and other such things of this game Street Fighter that were already available on the internet. So that helped us to solely focus on the implementation of the game without worrying about the design, the asset design itself, which is a time consuming process. However, many other process, the assets that we used within this game were also designed by ourselves to follow a specific theme design throughout the game. For example, main menu screens, exit screens, sound screens, map select screens, player select screens and move instructions menu were made by ourselves, mostly using Photoshop and other such photo editing tools. In the previous videos that I have uploaded on this channel, you can find out the full details of the coding, UML design, classes, design techniques, assets and code integration tools and techniques that we have used to make this game. So if you want to get a complete overview of this game, I would suggest watching that playlist named Object Oriented Programming Final Project, which contained total of 6 videos. I wanted to make this video as a final demonstration of the game and to talk about the potential changes and extensive room for the betterment of the game design and overall style and efficiency of the game. So let me just dive into the game and talk about the features implemented in it. The main menu, as you can see, consists total of 4 main options. The exit button will prompt the user to exit screen, asking the user to confirm exit or prompt back to the main menu itself. The sound menu include options for on and off sound on and off and sound intensities. Let me show you the functionalities of these sound menu buttons. Similarly, difficulty option allows total of 3 difficulty levels. Each difficulty is marked by the strength of the opposite player, which in our case would be computer itself. As of now, our implementation for each difficulty is marked by probability at which the moves of other players will be generated at interval spaced by some time that will also mark by the difficulty selected. For example, harder the difficulty will be, shorter will be the intervals between each move of the computer player. And similarly, higher the difficulty will be, the greater will be the probability of the move generations. Similarly, easier level will cause longer delays between each moves with low probability of the moves generation that will help us damage the computer player more. So next we have the play button, which will advance the user towards selecting the arena screen. So we added total of 18 arenas, some of which were included directly from the Street Fighter game itself, while the other were included, which were selected from different GIFs that we found relevant to be included here. From these GIFs, we extracted the sprite sheets using different tools and implemented these arenas, which you can see here. So selecting any of the arena will lead the user to selecting the player screen. We went total of 10 players similarly, primarily because each player had its separate move, separate special move, which had to be implemented separately. Hence, there was significant amount of work that had to be done for each player. Otherwise, we could have included more than 10 players as well. So once we select the player, it will lead to the important instruction screen, as you can see. This screen carries all the relevant information regarding game setting, the in-game functionalities such as of life, power bars, working, the time of the round, which is 90 seconds, functioning of a special power and other such information. Once we select the next or play, we are prompted to this screen of the player control and the move. So we went with usual keys mostly used in fighting games, such as WASD for the movements of up, down, left and right, PK for punches and kicks, and these combinations of these punch and kick with the crouch as well. Similarly, for a special move, we used IO keys for the two special moves of each player. Once the player is familiarized with the moves and attacks, they will be prompted to the opposition screen, which shows the selected player and opposite player facing each other for some time, as you can see. The screen is then followed by the actual game itself. As you can see, within the game we included the opposite player pictures. As you can see, their life bar and special power bar, a timer, and a return to the main menu button. Here, life will continue to decrease upon the hits if they are taken, and power bar will be recovered once used at the pace determined by the difficulty level. As you can see, let me use the special power. As you can see, I just used a special power. Also, you can notice the timer running, which decides the length of one round, which is total of 90 units. Similarly, you can see the player responses when I press any of the action key, for example, jump, move left, move right, crouch, punch, and kick, and also the special power. Also, the special power of my player. So, the goal of the game is simple in itself. The player has to defeat or finish off the opposite player life before the time runs out, otherwise the game will be over. Similarly, if our selected player life goes out before the time, then we lose the game. You can also notice how the bot player, that is the computer, have very vague movements and actions at this point, the reason for which is the random generation for the moves. The idea was to basically train the bot, which is the computer, according to the difficulty level, which is basically one of the potential possible aspect of the game which I talked about earlier. Currently, the bot isn't trained as much, and hence the non-smart movements and actions is what you are seeing. So the idea is to basically train the bot further so as to improve the accuracy and the probability of move generations. For example, when only the opposite player is in the vicinity of the bot, only then the action such as punch or kick should be generated. Similarly when to call the block or the crouch of or jump of bot should be called in accordance with the movement of the other player. Difficulty should also be decided on how often these moves should be called, so that will be an important factor of difficulty. So we wanted to base these actions and movements of the computer bot on the key inputs with which we control our player, like what kind of behavior should bot respond with upon a specific key press. Similarly, with this potential in bot training, the movement of the players could also be improved. As you saw, the punches and kicks exchanged between the player were not very smooth, as you can see here. So the player were punches and kicks doesn't give a very smooth sense of a collision. Thus, you could also improve the collision between the players and also make the collisions more efficient. For example, rather than only detecting the collision of player rectangles, we can sort of cut rectangles according to the body of the player and then detect the collision to make them more efficient and visually pleasing. So the overall fight have tons of room for the improvement, both in terms of bot algorithm and collision detections. Similarly, in-game fight itself holds a lot of potential for improvement. Other improvements could also be made within the menu design, for example, adding a back button for map selection, player selection, and other screens. Similarly, adding a load save game button, which will keep track of the previous game and the user can load that game to play that again. For sound menu, we can add other functionalities as well, for example, such as slider to control the volume, and number of other improvements. So this is pretty much it for the current overall progress of the game, and as far as possible room for improvements are concerned. I might upload a video in future if I will be working on any of these suggested improvements, but for now that's it. So Allah Hafiz for now, stay safe and take care.